A blessed day to everyone. For this lesson, we will discuss about the two topics, which are the green consumerism and also the market segmentation. So for this topic, we were going to discuss about the disadvantages and even the advantages of having a green consumerism, even the importance of green consumerism, and also the green marketing strategy, and how can we discover value via market analysis. And this time, we can also know the level of market segmentation, the target market, and even the positioning and its type, and the benefits of market positioning. Let's start. Now, what is green consumerism? By the definition, this is the state in which consumers demand products and services that have undergone an eco-friendly production process or one that involves recycling and safeguarding the planet's resources. So, napakadaming gumagawa nito. Okay, napakadaming business na gumagawa nito na kung saan meron naman din talaga kasing demand. May mga consumer na sobrang careful no, sa pagbili ng kanilang mga supplies or sa pagbili ng kanilang mga commodity. It always need to be eco-friendly for them. Because of having this kind of state of our consumers' demand, nagkakaroon ng opportunity yung ating mga businesses to have an innovation about their product. And also, this opportunity can give a lot of new production or even to promote their product and also advancement of utilization or use of goods or services based on their pro-environmental benefits. Why is these things happen? So, alam naman natin na yan because of some of the effects no, ng ating tinatawag na global warming, napakadami pong ang nagkakaroon na ng tinatawag na malasakit no, sa ating environment. And because of this, ayan, nagiging part na siya ng social attitudes and also a movement on our modern era. So especially, no, aiming and also encouraging people that we need to be aware of the firm's production processes and only to buy or use product and services that do not harm the environment. So because of this one, si client or si buyers, ayan, nagkakaroon siya ngayon ng pagkakaroon ng balanse doon sa kanyang binavalue yung product and also doon sa nagiging behavior niya okay, sa pagbili ng product. Now, these are the advantages and disadvantages of having this one. So now, let's start with the advantages. First is that the company can enter new markets when it's bring attention to positive environmental impact. Well, obviously, once we talk about having economic friendly ano ng ating mga commodities, ayan, nagkakaroon talaga ito ng opportunity sa business. Bakit? Kasi nakukuha niya yung attention ng society na kung saan yung produkto niya ay hindi nakaka-harm. By having different kind of marketing strategy, that this kind of strategy is about the information of the product or yung services na ino-offer ni business. One of the best example for this is the packaging ng mga produkto no, na binibili natin. So doon makikita natin yung mga tinatawag na friendly reminders on how can we dispose yung mga commodities na to o yung mga product na to. Like for example, paano ito i-recycle or paano ito itatapon ng maayos or let's say, through packaging, nakikita natin yung labels, kung ano yung mga component or kung ano ba yung mga chemical na ginamit para dito. At yung mga chemical na yun, obviously, dapat hindi ito nakaka-harm si sa environment. So, by having this kind of product, so ayan, nagkakaroon ng attention ngayon or nakukuha natin yung attention ng market to flag or to advertise our product. Next is gain more profit from green marketing. So, sa panahon kasi ngayon, ayan, maram dahil nga ang informasyon ay napakadaling ma-access and even yung mga yung information na to, it's either bad or good. Ayan. So makikita natin or mababasa natin agad. So yung pinaka nagiging disadvantages no nito is yung kapag yung product mo na nilabas sa market ay nagkaroon ng link kung paano ito ginawa ng hindi maganda. So, automatically, hindi ito nakakatulong sa green marketing. Hindi siya nagiging profitable. Now, if your product have a lot of contains na kung saan, yun, hindi nga siya nakaka-harm sa environment, at kita or visible doon sa information na to, na yung paggamit ng product na to ay hindi na nakakatulong sa'yo, but also, it cannot harm the environment, napakalaki po ng possibility na magkaroon tayo ng more profit. Another advantages is about green marketing brings a competitive advantage. Bakit po ito nangyayari? So again, ulitin natin. Because of this era, ayan, nagiging conscious tayo sa pagbili ng produkto. Bakit? Kasi ramdam natin, no, yung tinatawag na climate change o yung pagbabago-bago ng panahon or pagbabago-bago ng klima dahil nga sa different pollutions. Now, by offering the different kind of product that can help the environment, we need to have a lot of testing, we need to have a lot of innovation, we need to have a lot of research, or we need to have a lot of testing and error and so on. So, abang ginagawa natin ito and we become more successful doing this one, ibig lang sabihin, nagiging unique yung product natin. So, dahil nagiging unique yung product natin, automatically, yung product natin, ayan, nagiging competitive din ito sa market. And for the last advantage is about raise awareness on the important environmental or social issues. So most of the time, no, yung mga product na kung saan organic o kaya naman less chemical or no chemical at all, ayan, nakiki-tie up sila, no, sa mga different agency na kung saan may concern, no, sa environment. So by having this kind of tie-up, most of the time they have an event or training or workshop para po mas lalong maging aware hindi lang po yung kanyang consumer but even the entire society with regards to their product on how this product can be helpful with the environment and how to address the social issues by availing or by purchasing a kind of product that will not harm the environment. And also, we have some disadvantages. First is change leads to cost. Alam naman natin na the more na naging organic ang product, the more na lumalaki yung gastos. Bakit? Kasi we need to have a lot of experimentation para po hindi ma-harm ang environment. And also, this is very challenging. Why? Kasi nga, you need to come up with a lot of new strategy which is typically translate into increase of our cost. While your sustainable efforts or even the practices of the companies are designed to save money when the company puts effort into changing their brand to be more environmentally friendly, they choose changes can have expensive and fun costs. And also cost green certification. So once we talk about costly green certification, ayan, nag-a-ask tayo na ma-certified yung ating produkto na ito talaga ay environmental friendly. But before, syempre itong ma-certified, you need to have a lot of proof. And itong proof na to, yung documentations na to, it's definitely costly, no? Syempre kapag kumuha ka ng certificate, it's not just about local but even national or kung gusto mo mag-expand ka even international. So marami kang kailangang certificate na kunin para po ma-certified na yung product mo talaga ay isang environmental friendly. And for the last is the greenwashing. So once we talk about greenwashing, ito yung pagpapakita sa society na okay yung product mo, hindi ito ay nakaka-pollute, pero hindi naman talaga 100% na hindi nakakapollute yung product mo sa environment. That is what we call greenwashing. Kumbaga, sinasabi mo sa madla na 100% okay yung product mo, hindi makaka-harm, pero hindi talaga yun yung facts. Okay, so that's why it's called greenwashing. Example, having a disposable water. So, may mga company na sinasabi nila na yung mga pag-dispose sila ng mga, let's say, waste, ganyan, hindi ito nakaka-harm sa environment. Pero, entirely of their production process, nakaka-pollute talaga ito. Bakit? Kasi po, kahit finiltered na nila yung kanilang mga waste, hindi talaga po maiiwasan na nagkakaroon pa rin ito ng chemicals or meron pa rin itong mga substance na nakaharm sa water natin. Now, why is it important po to have the green consumerism? First is to reduce waste in packaging. So, dito, nung nagkakaroon tayo ng advocacy, kung paano natin malilimitahan yung paggamit ng mga different print or yung mga ink, no, kung tawagin. Kasi kapag ka more simple, more conducive, no, yung packaging natin, hindi talaga ito nakaka-harm sa ating environment. So, one of the best example there is about the, let's say, yung paggamit ng mga karton o kaya yung paggamit ng mga sandbags, ganyan, instead of using plastics. And also, the second one is increase energy efficiency. Ayan, napakadami ng gumagawa nito, lalo na po if you are dealing about appliances. Ayan. So, alam naman natin na mataas ang kuryente natin o mataas ang nagiging billing natin per kilowatt. So, if you're going to buy appliances, you need to take a look, no, about the voltage or about the consumption, kung gaano ba kalaki yung konsumo nito or kung gaano ba kalaking kilowatts per hours yung pwedeng kainin ng appliances or ng gadget na bibili natin. Why? Because we need to reduce the bills. And also, kapag po ginagawa natin ito, ayan, mas talo pong bumababa yung tinatawag natin na emission of greenhouse gas. And it can also meet the growing energy demand. So through this kind of green consumerism, yung ating environment at yung ating economy ay nagbe-benefit. Kumbaga, nagiging 2:1 siya. Okay, in terms of increased energy efficiency. And then the third one is decrease release of emissions and other pollutants during productions and transportation processes. So, alam natin yan, yung carbon print, kung tawagin. Ibig sabihin, nakakadagdag tayo, no, sa pagkakaroon ng pollution. So, saan po ba nanggagaling yung mga emissions na to? So, one of the best example there is yung mga transportation. Except, syempre, yung tinatawag natin na na bike, yan, hindi naman talaga yan nakaka-pollute, no? Yung syempre, mga nakaka-pollute dyan is yung mga gumagamit ng gas, which are yung mga buses natin, yung mga motor, mga ganyan. So, yun, nakakadagdag sila, no, sa pollutant. Even yung mga industry or yung mga pabrika, okay, they are producing emission. And then the last is the consumption of more healthy foods. Ayan. If you're going to remember, di ba, during yung kasagsagan ng pandemic, so lahat naging health conscious dahil nga bawal ang mahina ang sistema o yung immune system. So, mas lalo tayong nagpa-patronize ng mga product na kung saan mas magiging kapakipakinabang sa ating kalusugan. Now, we also have some strategies, no, in terms of green marketing. First, we need to be transparent. Ayan. So, pag sinabing transparent, whatever the compositions or whatever the ingredients of your product, ayan, it must be visible or it must be aware, no, yung ating mga consumer. And then, walking the talk. So, kapag po ang isang business ay talagang nag-o-offer siya, hindi lang para kumita, kundi to commit talaga, no, yung business na to for the environment, ito po ay nagiging part na, no, ng kanilang advocacy. At since ito ay part na ng kanilang advocacy, klaro, no, klaro na ito yung talagang kanilang visions, and it can really help to solve the so-called environment problem. And by doing this, so ang ating mga businesses, they need to be proactive, no, in dealing or participating in every solution that they can do to not harm the environment or to minimize some of the waste. So that's why some of the businesses, they have the so-called corporate social responsibility strategy. So dito, binavalue nila yung kanilang pagkakaroon ng utang na loob sa community. So kumbaga, ito yung tinatawag natin na giving back to community. So having this kind of thing, ayan, they need to be have a good communication, no, sa ating mga consumers about the product, ano ba yung matutulong ng product sa kanila, and how the entire company can help the society. Not just about the product, but also how the entire businesses cannot add to the so-called waste. And then, the fourth strategy is producing durable products that ensure extended utility over their life cycle. As much as possible, yung mga businesses natin, yung mga industry na produce ng different product, yung product na kanilang ilalabas is magagamit ng napakatagal na panahon. Bakit? Kasi syempre kapag ka ang produkto ay, let's say, disposable, so dahil disposable ito, ito ay nagiging dagdag lang, no, doon sa tinatawag natin na waste. And then for the last is the cost, marketing, eco labels, and environmental product declarations. So like what I said kanina, napakalaking tulong po na magkaroon ng different kind of certificate to know the public that your businesses have certified or are certified that your product are eco-friendly. Now, let's talk about discovering value via market analysis. So, we have here the market segmentation. So, I know that you are very much familiar with this. So, once we talk about market segmentation, this is the process of dividing a market into group or subgroup of consumers of common characteristics. So, bakit natin din i-divide? Para po, syempre, malaman natin agad kung paano natin masusolusyonan ang pangangailangan at ang kagustuhan ng ating mga consumers. Now, we also have here the label of segmentation and the types of segmentation. So, once we talk about mass market, lahat pwede natin maging consumers. Kumbaga, ito yung tinatawag natin na all walks of life. Kumbaga, from matanda hanggang sa bata, ayan, they are part of our market. So, one of the best example there is the water. So, lahat kailangan talaga ng tubig. Next is the market segment. So, pag sinabi naman natin market segments, nagkakaroon ka na ng pagdi-divide or let's say, sinisegments mo na yung market mo. It depends on their references, it depends on their needs, or it depends on their wants. And also, we have the so-called niche market. And once we talk about niche market, this is having a special area of demand of a product or a services that you can deliver or you can provide to our market. So like for example, the need of a specialization of the product or service, or the need to have a differentiation, or nagkakaroon ka ng different variety of product or different variety of service. So in here, you can be able to stand out from the crowd. Why? Because you have a variety of product and also different kinds of services. And for the last is the individual. So once we talk about individual, your product is specific. So meaning, your product is specific to individual. Example, yung mga customized product natin o kaya naman in terms of medicine. So, they have a specific medicine for a certain illness. So, that is what we call individual. And also, we have the types of market segmentation. So, once we talk about demographic segmentation, we are referring with the personal data or personal information. So, in here, we divide overall our market into homogeneous group based on the different variable, example, their gender, their income, their age, their occupation, their education, and even their sexual orientation, even the sizes of household, and the stage and the family life cycle. And also, we have the psychographic segmentation. So, once we talk about psychographic segmentation, we have to divide the population into groups having similar attitudes, values, and even the lifestyles. And also, we have the geographic segmentation. And geographic segmentation, it definitely dealing with their location. And also, for the last is the behavioral segmentation. In behavioral segmentation, it's definitely about how our buyer purchase a product. So this is about the behavior or some of the influences how they choose or how they buy a product. Example, if the buyer or the consumers buy it occasionally purposes, or they buy it because they get some benefits from it, or it's either the customers are being loyal to a certain product, so that's why even though we change different packaging or let's say we have new product, they still patronizing our business. Next, let's talk about the target market. So, dahil nga po we have a pools of our consumers or the overall market, so this time, para po hindi masayang yung effort natin, we need to specify or we need to really know, no, who are our target market. So, these are a set of buyers sharing common needs or characteristics that the company decides to serve. And also, we have here the market positioning and its type. So, once we talk about positioning, ano po ba ang nasa utak ng mga consumers or ng society in terms of our brand? Kumbaga, ano po ba ang nagiging branding, no? Paano na po ba nakikilala ng ating society or ng ating community ang ating business? First is we have the category base. So, pag sinabi natin category base, you have different variety of products. Kumbaga, marami silang pwedeng pagpilian. And also, we have the so-called consumer's base. It deals with... Second is about the consumer base. So, pag sinabi natin consumer base, this kind of product po ba ay tumutugma doon sa pangangailangan or doon sa lifestyle ng ating mga consumers. Example, yung mga sport, yan, yung mga sporty natin. So, may mga different brand, no, na kung saan pinapatronize. For example, Nike, yan, for sport, or let's say, Adidas, mga ganyan. So, that is what we call consumer base. And also, we have the competitors base. And competitive base naman, this is how a certain business become differentiated to others. So, dito, nagkakaroon sila ng iba't ibang offer, or itong offering na to is nang kakaroon ito ng different value sa market. Bakit? Kasi nga po, ito yung tinatawag na uniqueness nila sa market. And also, we have the benefit. In terms of benefits, ito naman po yung attributes or yung naibibigay ng product na ito doon sa consumers. Example, kung ito po ba ay damit, ayan, nagkakaroon sila ng expression of their lifestyle. Also, example, during school year, mga ganyan, pagbukas ng klase, so bumibili ng mga different school supplies. Why? Because this kind of product have benefits to their educations. And also, we have the price. So, dito, we're talking about the worth it, no, ng produkto Kumbaga, hindi masasayang yung pera mo kapag ka bumili ka sa ganitong brand or sa ganitong types of products. And also, we have the attribute. So, once we can talk about attributes naman, this is a specific use or a specific features of a certain product to address the needs or the wants of our consumers. And for the last is what we have, the prestige. So, pag sinabing prestige, here we're talking about luxury goods or let's say yung mga luxury services. So, one of the best example there, if you're going to, let's say, book a flight, going to somewhere, ayan, so yung prestige natin dyan, if you book into business class seats. And now, we also have here the benefits of market positioning. So, una dyan is nagkakaroon tayo ng tinatawag na competitive edge. So, pag sinasabing competitive edge, ito yung uniqueness ng product, ito yung angat ka, dito ka magaling, if you're going to compare to your competitors, and also, because of this competitive edge, napakadali pong mag-promote kapag po meron kang bagong produktong ilalabas. And through these things, you can also create a brand identity. Ibig sabihin, you have the so-called branding. Meron ka ng tinatawag na pangalan, kung tawagin. Kung baga may identity ka na kung ano ba yung brand or kung ano ba yung product mo. And for the last is marketing positioning simplifies the purchase decision for customers. Bakit? Kasi nasa utak na nila or let's say automatic na na nasa kaisipan nila, no, once they are looking for a specific product, they can choose your business. Why? Because it's very... So then, if they are going to purchase a certain product, napakadaling mag-decide kung saan sila bibili nito. Bakit kasi po, is it because they are already aware what kind of product or what kind of services ang ino-offer ni business? And that's it. Thank you so much for listening.